My name is Janelle Delorme. I am the Regional Animator for Development and Peace, Caritas Canada, here in Manitoba, and I will be your MC for the evening. Je m'appelle Janelle Delorme. Je suis l'animatrice régionale à Développement et Paix pour le Manitoba, et je serai votre maîtresse de cérémonie pour la soirée. It is with great pleasure that I welcome you all at the Université de Saint-Boniface. Bienvenue à tous et à toutes à l'Université de Saint-Boniface. Ce soir, la projection du film sera en anglais, mais sachez que Waël Kabbani, le producteur délégué, répondra à des questions dans les deux langues et je ferai de mon possible pour le traduire. So please be aware that tonight's screening will be in English, but that the Q&A will be bilingual, allowing for people to ask questions in the language of their choice. And I will try to roughly translate YL when questions are asked en français. I'll translate it to English. Before we begin, I would like to acknowledge that we are here on Treaty 1 territory, the traditional lands of the Anishinaabe, Cree, Oji-Cree, Dakota, and Dene peoples, and the traditional homeland of the Métis Nation. Along with Development and Peace, tonight's event is being co-hosted by the Canadian-Palestinian Association of Manitoba, Independent Jewish Voices Winnipeg, the United Jewish People's Order, the United Church of Canada Conference of Manitoba and Northwestern Ontario, the United Network for Justice and Peace in Palestine and Israel, Mennonite Central Committee Manitoba, and the Comité de Développement et Paix de l'Université de Saint-Boniface. At this time, I would like to invite Caitlin Sutton, the President of Development and Peace Committee here at the Université de Saint-Boniface. J'aimerais à ce moment inviter Caitlin Sutton, la présidente du Comité de Développement et Paix à l'Université de Saint-Boniface, à vous adresser la parole.
Bonsoir tout le monde. Au nom du Comité de Développement et Paix de l'Université de Saint-Boniface, j'ai le grand plaisir de vous accueillir ici parmi nous. Je suis heureuse que notre comité a pu servir d'hôte et de fournir le lieu pour cet événement qui sera très intéressant. Étant un groupe universitaire qui vise la sensibilisation envers les enjeux qui affectent nos frères et sœurs dans d'autres parties du monde, nous sommes ravis de faire partie de cette importante occasion d'apprentissage qui pourrait aussi être une occasion de voir une nouvelle perspective au sujet de ce thème. Je veux aussi remercier Waël Kabbani d'être ici avec nous ce soir. Nous sommes vraiment chanceux et chanceuses d'avoir cette occasion de lui accueillir parmi nous. J'ai eu la chance de parler avec Waël cet après-midi et il est vraiment évident que c'est un homme qui est vraiment passionné de la justice sociale et de tous les projets qu'il travaille pour, qui visent à créer une sensibilisation au sujet des différents événements à travers le monde qui sont souvent peu reportés dans les médias. Alors, bienvenue à tous et bonne soirée. Welcome, everyone. On behalf of the Development and Peace Committee here at the University of St. Boniface, I am pleased to welcome you here this evening. I am very grateful that our committee is able to provide the space for this evening tonight. Our Development and Peace Committee seeks to raise awareness about the realities that those in different parts of the world are facing. And tonight, we are excited to have this excellent opportunity to learn and perhaps glean a new perspective on the situation in Bethlehem. I also want to thank Waël Kabbani for being here with us tonight. We are very fortunate to have this opportunity. I had the chance to speak with Waël this afternoon, and it was really obvious that he's a man who's very passionate about social justice and all the projects that he's working on. Once again, good evening and welcome.
Merci, Caitlin. At this time, I would like to invite Rana Abdullah, who is representing the Canadian-Palestinian Association of Manitoba, and she has a message for all of us.
Oh, Okay, bonsoir tout le monde. I'm from the Canadian Palestinian Association of Manitoba, a non-for-profit organization that promotes the Palestinian and Arab culture to bridge communities and create better understanding of who we are, of our heritage, of our culture, and our cause. So before we proceed, we feel that it is important to recognize that we are gathered here today on Treaty 1 territory. We would like to acknowledge and thank the diverse indigenous people whose footsteps have marked the territory for centuries, including the Anishinaab and Cree, Oji, Dakota, Dene, and Métis. As we assert our opposition to Israeli apartheid and our solidarity with the Palestinian people, we feel we cannot speak meaningfully about Israeli apartheid without acknowledging the realities of similar system here in Canada. Canada's reservation system and treatment of Indigenous people was closely studied by the planners of apartheid in South Africa. Though this is a hidden chapter of our history, we recognize that from the very beginning of the founding of Canada was built on the theft of Indigenous land and the genocide and displacement of Indigenous peoples. If you are with us in opposition to Israeli apartheid, we encourage your consistent opposition to the elements of similar systems here in Canada. Finally, in the interest of having an open dialogue, we would like to stress that the organizers of the event urge all participants to engage on these issues in a respectful manner. We categorically reject and will not in any way tolerate instances of Islamophobic, anti-Semitic, or other racist behavior during the event. Thank you.
Merci beaucoup, Rena. Malheureusement, Leila Sansour ne pouvait pas être avec nous ce soir et nous envoie ses salutations. Leila Sansour, the director and star of Open Bethlehem, could not be among us tonight, and she sends her regards. Leila is an acclaimed filmmaker with an unconventional portfolio. She is the founder and CEO of Open Bethlehem, an organization that works to bring international commitment to the resolution of the Israeli-Palestinian question, using Bethlehem as a gateway into the situation. Leila's latest film, Open Bethlehem, was released in the UK at Christmas in 2014, 10 years after she began her project at Christmas in 2004. The film was shot over 5 years in Bethlehem during the building of the Israeli wall and has resulted in the gathering of the largest visual archive of the city, both past and present. Open Bethlehem follows Leila's extraordinary journey to the legendary city of Bethlehem, the place where she grew up. Armed with a camera and a family car that keeps breaking down, she sets out to make an intimate portrait of a historical town in peril. 10 years on, with 700 hours of footage, the result is nothing like she had expected. Alors, je vous souhaite un bon visionnement. I hope you enjoy the film. So it is with great pleasure that I'd like to introduce to you Waël Kabbani, executive producer of Open Bethlehem. C'est mon honneur d'inviter Waël Kabbani, producteur délégué de Bethlehem Ville Ouverte, à s'asseoir devant nous. Waël. Waël is the executive creative director for Iambic Dream Inc. He provides leadership and guidance and drives the company's mission to engage through all forms of storytelling. He is passionate about the power of creativity and the people who make it happen. Waël is truly a global citizen. with a Syrian-Saudi background, school years in Switzerland, a decadent decade and a half in California, and a vibrant life in London and a home base in Montreal. Phew. Okay, so this I know for a fact, Waël is also known to be a foodie. We have brought him to wonderful, wonderful restaurants here in Winnipeg, and he's always on the prowl for an exceptional meal. He diligently seeks out fascinating life experiences as a storyteller and passionately tells his stories through not only film, but through music and animation, often combining all three creative mediums into one project. Waël Kabbani and Iambic Dream Films seem to have a gift for backing films that have become critically acclaimed. So in addition to being the executive producer of Open Bethlehem, he is also the executive producer of We Are Many and Life is Sacred. Currently, Waël and his independent film production company are supporting and co-producing 8 other documentaries. Bienvenue, Waël.
Thank you, Janelle. Am I on? I'm not sure. Yes, thank you, guys. Thank you, Janelle, and Developments in Peace. Thank you all for being here. I know Monday night there's a lot of things you could be doing, so we really appreciate you being here. Wanted to also thank all the co-organizers and my host, David, who's been very gracious to let me stay in his home. So thank you very much, David. We'll talk more about the organizers a little later, but wanted to just say that I am so impressed with Winnipeg. It's my first visit, and I've had such a wonderful experience. The only reason I'm actually anxious to get back to Montreal is I got to hit the gym. I've gained quite a few kilos in just like 3 or 4 nights, thanks to Janelle and all the other wonderful hosts here. So thank you for that.
We can take our
Okay, sure.
So as we collect people's burning questions, I will ask the first question. Why was it so important for you as an executive producer to back the Open Bethlehem documentary as well as the entire project?
Well, I've always found that, you know, Palestine and the Palestinian-Israeli situation was something very important that needed to be discussed, and we weren't really seeing all sides of the story in the mainstream media, especially in North America, I think, but in other places as well. I wanted to support a film and a filmmaker that was telling a story, a personal story about Palestine. It wasn't good enough for me to be passionate about Palestine. I wanted to actually find a very powerful, intelligent human story, and that's what I came across with Open Bethlehem. So for me, it was very, very important. Once I was invited to watch the film, most of the film was actually finished. It was one of those rare situations where I had heard about the film, but it wasn't finished, and I'd seen like maybe 15 seconds, I should say, of a teaser. It was just a teaser, 15 seconds. It really didn't say much, didn't really move me the way the finished film did, or most of the film that I saw. Obviously, we've made a few changes here and there, but it was mostly what you've seen, I mean, with a few additions and edits. So it was just so powerful. And once I learned about the campaign as well and the nonprofit, you know, I was invited to join the board, and I really couldn't refuse. I mean, I do all of this on a voluntary basis. It's one of the films where, you know, the money that I've put in obviously is a donation, and I've raised some money as well from friends and family and other people I know. But we do really appreciate all the donations that have come in. You know, even if you buy the DVD for $20, it does make a difference. You know, you get the English and French version of the film. And as Janelle, you know, mentioned, we'd love to come back and screen the film again here and in other places. We were fortunate through Developments in Peace and other sponsors to screen the film in Montreal in French and in English and in Toronto and in Vancouver and in Edmonton. And it's been a real pleasure to screen it here for you as well. Je sais pas, je voulais remercier tout le monde de toute manière et dire que ça fait un vrai plaisir d'être là et que les gens de Winnipeg sont très très gentils et c'est un honneur d'être ici avec tous les gens, vous et aussi les organisateurs, parce qu'il y a au moins 6 ou 7 organisateurs et organisations qui ont participé dans ce screening. On va les mentionner, bien sûr. Je ne sais pas, est-ce que je les mentionne maintenant ou un peu plus tard? Merci.
So this is actually a really great question. What has been the reaction, if any, from the Israeli government to this project?
Well, that's a very good question. I don't know that the Israeli government knows that much about Open Bethlehem. We've been invited to screen the film at Jewish film festivals and by Jewish organizations in the U.S. And the reaction's been mostly very positive. I think this film, you know, another thing that I didn't mention is the reason I picked this film is I believe it's really more of a dialogue. It opens dialogue and conversations, and that was also important for me when picking a film about peace and conflict resolutions. I think, you know, we also had some very surprising reactions. A friend of Leila's in London, England, invited her and several people who are very, you know, they would call themselves right-wing and probably Zionist as well, which actually they called themselves Zionist, but you know, not everyone fits a stereotype when you talk about right-wing and Zionist. But in those particular cases, two of the gentlemen that came to the screening said that they had their mindset about Israel and nothing's going to change it. And you know, and a lot of people, you know, on both sides might feel that way. But something really surprising happened at that private screening. Initially, the two gentlemen were very kind of standoffish and, you know, giving Leila the cold shoulder and stuff. But at the end of the film, one of them said, you know, I haven't changed my opinion, but it's made me think and I don't like it, okay? And the other person actually said he's beginning to think about, he never thought he'd say this, but he was beginning to think about the situation in Israel and Palestine very differently. And, you know, we're not always going to get those kind of reactions. But when we do, it means that even if we touch or move one person who's going to be unwavering usually, you know, that means that we've done something. And I think at the Jewish Film Festival, I asked Leila, I wasn't there at that screening in San Francisco. I lived in San Francisco for 8 years, and we had kind of a mixed reaction. We had a standing ovation by, I'd say, a third of the audience. We had a third that got up after the film and just left, so we don't really know exactly, you know, what they felt. And then the other third seemed pretty neutral. So we didn't really have, we haven't really had any issues. And Leila is very happy to not just screen the film to what I call or we call the choir. We'd like to have dialogue and we'd like to have conversations with people. So as Janelle said, I'll be back there after the Q&A if anyone would like to talk. And, you know, we'd like to build bridges instead of walls. We really do. So, merci.
Merci, Waël. So how does one get into Bethlehem today?
Well, Bethlehem, we actually help organize. We work with tour guides and, you know, basically travel agencies. And we're trying to actually, we have a list on our website that gives you a different kind of visit of Bethlehem. So you could actually contact us or go on the website and see different organizations and, you know, tour guides and tour operations that will show you a Palestinian side of Bethlehem. And, you know, you could see in the film that generally the Israeli tour buses will whisk their, you know, tourists in for about 45 minutes to an hour, rush them through the Nativity Church. And the whole purpose of people coming to Bethlehem is there's a lot more to see and a lot more to do. And I think when you talk to people that live in Bethlehem, you realize that it's really a diverse community of people, and we'd like to keep it that way, and we'd like to keep Bethlehem open, obviously. So there are many ways that we can help you and work with you to make sure. And you know, Leila spends a lot of time still in Bethlehem, even though she is traveling to film festivals and other screenings. And she will be coming to Canada, to the East Coast. We've got some, if you have any friends or relatives or anyone you think would find this film interesting, we will be in Montreal, first in Toronto, Mississauga, and Oakville. We've had interest to have screenings there. And that would be, we're expecting that to be the first week of May. And la seconde semaine de May, on sera à Montréal and in Ottawa et peut-être à Québec City aussi, Québec City.
So of course we saw in the documentary that this wall is 8 meters high, which is double the height of the Berlin Wall, which I couldn't even imagine. And the next question is, what is the role of the Israeli peace camp in the Open Bethlehem project against the wall? And is the wall also keeping Israelis out of Palestinian villages? So how kind of permeable is this wall?
Well, the wall is very, very tricky because, first of all, I mean, obviously, as you saw in the film, the excuse for the wall is that it's for the security of Israel. And obviously, if you want security and you really want to build a wall, you should build it on your side. Don't build it and chop up some, you know, occupied territory or someone else's city or country or state. So that's one of the contentions, obviously. But also, the wall is ineffective because lots of Palestinians can actually go through the wall, and they do on a daily basis. You know, obviously, there are areas where it's very difficult to cross without going through many checkpoints. And as you saw, one of the most moving scenes for me, there were many in the film, but when you see all these workers waiting since 3 a.m. to get to their jobs in Israel, and you know, they, for lack of a better term, they really were like caged animals waiting for 6-7 hours to get to work on time because there weren't many prospects in Bethlehem and other Palestinian cities. So, but I think, you know, it is very important that two of our co-organizers and co-sponsors are Jewish organizations, and we value working with Jewish organizations, Israelis. We have a professor, Professor Avi Shlem, who's an ambassador of Bethlehem and a friend of Open Bethlehem. So it's very important. We can't have peace without actually having both sides coming together. So again, this film for me is an opportunity to start dialogue with people who might not know the story, but also who are interested in finding ways to actually build bridges rather than build walls. The wall, you know, I'm very optimistic. It might take a very long time, but I'm optimistic that this wall, if we speak about it and we screen this film and other, you know, and people talk about what's happening in Palestine. Obviously, we use Bethlehem as a metaphor and a gateway for all of Palestine. So for me, that was also an intelligent thing that Leila did, where she actually, you know, she happens to be from a town, a city that many people can relate to. But also many people didn't even know it was in Palestine. So we actually did a survey in the UK and in the US. And, you know, we had people asking questions down the street, interviewing people. If you go on our website, you'll see a video. And the answers were remarkable. Most people thought it was, does it still exist? Did it ever exist? Is it a mythical place? Obviously it exists because Jesus was born there. But, you know, people would guess all kinds of things, and very few people knew that it was in Palestine. So that's also something where, you know, you're acknowledging where something is and that there is an issue and a problem. So.
Alors, notre prochaine question est en français, and I'll translate to English afterwards. Alors, où en est-on rendu avec le projet le projet d'Open Bethlehem dans les années récentes. So where are we at currently in terms of the Open Bethlehem project?
Alors, je vais pratiquer mon français. Merci pour la question. On est dans un temps très important pour le projet et pour le film, parce qu'on utilise ce film comme un véhicule pour montrer le monde et expliquer au monde qu'est-ce qui se passe à Bethléem et à la Palestine, dans la Palestine. Et on est en train de, raise funds.
Prélever des fonds, faire une collecte de fonds.
Oui, pour montrer le film partout aux États-Unis. On est en train de travailler avec beaucoup d'organisations, des non-profits. Par exemple, on a montré le film à 20 organisations juives à Washington, D.C. récemment, il y a quelques mois. Et ils étaient vraiment intéressés à montrer le film à leurs membres et aussi partager le film avec les chapitres différents partout aux États-Unis. Mais pas, bien sûr, eux aussi, ils ont des sources d'argent, pas beaucoup. Alors, il faut qu'on travaille ensemble. Et on aimerait faire comme un tour partout aux États-Unis, au Canada aussi. On est en train de travailler avec un distributeur d'éducation, parce qu'il y a beaucoup d'intérêt dans les universités aussi. Et on aimerait, pour nous c'est très important, une des raisons que Leila ne pouvait pas être là, c'est que ça coûte de l'argent bien sûr, et nous on préfère garder la plupart de l'argent qu'on prélève, merci, ma professeure Janelle, pour l'organisation aussitôt que possible. Alors là, on est dans un moment très important pour l'organisation, mais on a toujours des hauts et des bas. Par exemple, dans le film, vous avez vu qu'elle était vraiment au bas et après, elle a décidé de recommencer tout. Et heureusement qu'il y a plus, par exemple, Malala, qui est quelqu'un très bien connu au monde. Elle est aussi une ambassadrice de Bethlehem, et elle est aussi, il y a par exemple président Jimmy Carter, et vous avez vu Reverend Desmond Tutu. Alors on a la chance qu'on a des gens qui croient vraiment dans notre organisation, notre non-profit, et le film aussi, mais c'est difficile de demander de l'argent, mais c'est important pour nous, pour continuer notre travail, d'avoir assez d'argent de montrer le film partout et quand possible, bien sûr, d'avoir Leila, parce que moi, je ne suis pas aussi intéressant que Leila. Alors, je vous assure que quand elle est là, elle est très dynamique et je crois que peut-être un jour, elle pourra venir à Winnipeg aussi.
Do you want to translate your...
Sure,
I don't think I'm going to be able to...
Yeah, sorry, I go on and on, that's my thing, so I should stop and let you, but no. I'll try to... basically, where we're at, I think the question was, where are you at with the organization? And, you know, just to try to summarize what I said in French, basically, you know, like any other organization, you're going to have ups and downs. And in the film, you saw that Leila, you know, went all the way to the bottom and then decided to start all over again. So it's very important for us to show the film because we use the film really as a tool to educate people and inform people and have conversations with people. So, for example, we've shown the film to 20 Jewish organizations in Washington, D.C. a couple of months ago, and they were very interested in sharing the film with their members, screening it at different chapters all over the U.S. And, you know, we would really like to raise enough funds to have a cinematic release and really have an impactful release, because it's great to have screenings here and there, but what we try to do is, if we go somewhere, we try to have more than one screening. Like, it's been great because Janelle organized lots of events, including an interview, my first radio interview en français. So my dodgy français actually was okay. So, but, you know, we've also met lots of wonderful people here. So we'd like to work with you and really hopefully work together to have very impactful tours and screening schedules in both Canada and the US, because our focus for the next couple of years will be North America. And I think it's very important for not only people in Canada, but especially in the US, where they're really not getting these kind of stories in their mainstream media.